The workplace is evolving, and so businesses of all size have to adapt to this changing workforce and embrace this blended model, accommodating the combination of in-person as well as the virtual world. Hi everyone, this is Spurti Patil. I am the Senior Program Manager for Space Management in Microsoft Digital Team. We build the employee experiences. I got hired in Microsoft during the pandemic. My interview was completely virtual. My onboarding was completely virtual. And I just can't wait to come back to work and meet everyone in person. Given the experiences what we are building in our team, this gives me much more confidence because we have a much more virtual way of getting acclimatized with the actual physical world. Now we can see the physical world in a virtual way through indoor maps, also like see real-time events happening in the actual physical world, which is empowered by IoT and so many other social events which are happening around it. So an end-to-end user scenario would be something like what I would do if I have to come back to a Microsoft in a workplace is basically drive to the workplace, be able to find a suitable parking spot just close to my work area. Thinking about very simple things like even the dining and cafe experiences, we don't have to stand in the line anymore. We would be able to see the occupancy and the waiting times at different areas of a space. You can most focus on what is the most productive way of working for you, and that is implicitly taken care by the digital transformation and the experiences what we have built. The core of all of this is Azure Digital Twin. That is a place where we build the relationship between various segregated, siloed data. One of the biggest challenges in the industry for digital transformation is that every team and every other system has been accumulating so much of data, but they are not making sense when they are put together. We are bringing in connection between three different siloed data. One is a geospatial space management data. Second is the IoT sensor data, and the third is the people or the employee information which are connected to those spaces. And then that data flows to the digital twin. Along with that, we do the IoT sensor planning. So once you know the building and the space very well, you know how many sensors you require in a building and what kind of sensors you want, and the construction and other teams and facilities have to make arrangements to do installation of those sensors. From the back end, they get the details about the building, and then they plan that and they install the sensors. Once you install the different kinds of sensors, that captures the streaming data to event hubs. And these event hubs are set up by various vendor clouds. Then they go through the gateway. The gateway pretty much aggregates and stores and then forwards that data securely to the IoT hub. That is where it goes into the cloud. And based on the events, selected events are pushed into the digital twin. During all these things, Digital Twin is constantly creating the digital mapping between the IoT data, spatial data, and people twin to represent a model. And this model is sent across various different employee experiences. One is the kiosk solution, indoor navigation, and MyHub. And once that data resides over there, we can use it to enable a plethora of employee experiences over different canvases. An employee can enter a building, go to a kiosk and see which person he or she wants to meet and where are they located. And once they know who they want to meet or the place where they want to go, further on, the data coming from the digital twin is ingested in Data Lake, and we use Power BI and other custom built dashboards and analytics to build these reports. We make decisions on whether to build or lease more buildings to give more productive environment for the workforce. We are living in an age where things are changing really fast. We have a bigger responsibility as businesses of all size to give a much more productive environment for our workforce, and also give them that suitable flexibility to work remotely as well as, you know, physically at workplaces. And that is the problem what we are trying to solve by different approaches and by digital transformation.